Sorry about that. It's okay. No problem. Ooh, I got a bad roll on that one. Okay, so Tom's got ball in here on the 5 ball. So, we're actually tougher than normal. Gotta try to get position, so he's gonna play the combo with the 6. Like it. That's a nice little shot there. Don't know if the 7 clears the 10, but I'm totally sure. Don't think so, so he might have to come 2 rails underneath it. But, oh, it might clear, he's looking at it right now. So it's probably, it probably does clear, so he can probably just come out 1 rail. Play the 6, play the 7, then you have the 8 and the 10. Nice little shot there. Make up a little short bit. Make another option here. Maybe play 10, 7, 10 combo. Nice little shot there. From 10. All right, Tom gets the first game, first blood. He just got a bad tip off that. That was just off that. That far slack is wide open. Brian should get out here. The ball hand. All right. See how many players this. Well, Ryan overran that. And now he's gonna have to cut this on the side. And come on Ray on. Take the position on it. But we will. He gets a good bump. Got a good bump there. Nah, he's just gonna probably play a 3 ball. Play a 4 ball and a 5. Play a 3 in the corner, 4 on the side, 5 in the corner here. Where I would play it. Play for the 5. Get a good angle on the 8. Come across the table for the 9 and go down for the 10. Nah, different corner. Let's see if I'm close. I keep drawing this, so I can do that. Sorry, he's gonna fall. Oh, he's not. Pretty much not. Yeah. Oh, he's gonna spin this over. That's not characteristic of Ryan. Like I said, you know, for these guys, these pockets are tight. Keep him in, so he may have to go around first too. Or I think it's first again. I think he's going around first too, I think. Nope, okay, we're dealing with him right out. Not what he wanted. That was a very, very tough shot, especially when you're over the ball. Okay, people out there who listen in, when you're over the ball mass 80 around. So the difficulty of that shot is pretty tough. Is he gonna play safe or is he gonna kind of just? I would probably play safe, but being a shooter. So. Oh, he played safe. The only thing is that side pocket you have to watch out for. I have a ball in hand with the 9-10. Should be able to get out here. All right, hit that very well. Pocket this ball and it's going to be 1-1. Oh. shot. We got a 1-1 score. I was going to have a prediction. I think this match is going to go uphill now. Alright, made the ball on the break. Going to get a shot in the one. Could be an early round. He is getting on the shoot here. Oh, he's going to try. Looks like he's going to try for it. Yep. Nice shot. It's a great shot. Tail 8, we got Kyle Pepin playing Rob Piercer again, and it looks like Kyle's up 2-1. And then we got tail 2, we got 2-1. I think Richie Mancello's up 2-1 against Lucas. We got Kerry and Rob Hole. That looks like somebody's up 2-0. I think Kerry's up 2-0, I think. Nothing on the break. I want to give a big shout out to Mike DeMarco for putting on this tournament again. It's a great event. I think everybody had a good time tonight. So. Oh, I think we also have another match too on table 7. We got Jared DeMalia versus Tim Perry. That's a 1-1 right now. Kyle's going to go up 3-1 against Bob Pearson. Just 3-7 is a little tricky, so let's see what Ryan's going to do here. He got there. Yeah, looks like he's probably going to have to fit in this 3-ball and try to play safe. I think it really do much damage. I guess there's not much else you can do, yeah. fresh out there. Yeah, it's like the jump cue's coming out. You left them just enough that this is a very difficult shot, especially these size pockets. To jump this in to get position on the floor. Good try though, very good try. Didn't leave Ryan too much. That is what they call a jelly roll. All right. All right, now Tom's coming back to the table now. He's got a shot in the three. Let's see how he's gonna get onto the four now. I mean, you could bank this, try it that way, or look like you're going to jack up and try to come two rails out. Good shot. Now. And you should get out from here. Ryan's got a little short on that one. Two rails, or he could bank this. Like hold position at the cue ball. Brian's one of the top players here. That's a nice little shot there. Now he's going to put inside English and comes back and forth. Kyle's ahead on table number 8, 4-2. He makes this up. Rob here. Looks like Rich Maine's up 3-1. Yes, Lucas. This is a very, very, very difficult speed shot here on the 7th and the 7th of the year. Hitting this with any speed on this table is really difficult. So you kind of have to just let the rails go. Just hit it kind of like a soft, or like a soft speed. Very difficult shot. Most important thing is staying down in the shot. Yep, they stayed right down on that shot. Came up a little short on that. Thank you. a good little shot there by Brian. He's forcing Tom to kick now. Shot. Do you get the speed? Do you get that? That's a great little shot there. A great shot. Just hold down for time. Make a nine, hold down. It's perfect. All right, so we're going to even match 2-2. He's on his hair. He's up 4-1. He's Lucas. Made. Yeah. Looks like Ryan's gonna have to push. Tom's probably gonna get us back, or he can kick it, stick it. Let's see if he tries to kick it, stick it. Yep. Only thing is, if it goes in, he might be in trouble. There was a traffic in itself. Oh, Ryan speeds off there. There it is. Like I said earlier, folks, the speed control is very important. Especially in this match. Seeing these guys. We got Mr. Mike DeMarco coming back in.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Mark, I'm actually going to be giving you a friend right now.
Oh, me and Adam?
Okay. We're actually going to have Mr. Kevin Brulé.
Okay, that's fine.
If you guys don't know Kevin Brulé, he's an active member of the pool community in the area. He knows a lot of these guys, and he's got a lot of insight and guy all around, but he's definitely going to get in here and give you guys a little bit of his mind.
Oh, yes.
So I'm going to pass the microphone over to Mr. Kevin Brulé. Mr. Kevin Brulé, come on up, bro.
A chair.
I'm going to get you set up. I'll get you a chair and everything. Here you go.
Well, that's good. Mark, how you doing?
I'm good. How you doing, Kevin?
I'm good.
Thank you.
Right. Watching two of the best Rhode Island amateurs.
Yes, yeah. Yes. We got two right now, so.
Yeah, we had a good look at Tommy's kick game the last game when he makes that 8-ball, huh?
Yes, he did a very, very soft kick game. So let's see here.
Mike's getting me set up with a seat up here. So, Mark, you got the chat set up?
I don't know how to do that. I'm not sure. Mike?
Chat?
Yeah, technical difficulties with the chat.
Oh, well, that's always a good thing, though. When I'm watching on a live stream, I like chatting in and talking to Mikey when he's usually up in the booth or when Upstate does it.
Yeah.
But right now, it looks like Rye's up here with the... Yep. Look at the five.
It's probably going to play safe.
Yeah, duck by seven, maybe?
Yep.
Yep, he throws it pretty good. It's a good shot by Ryan.
Yeah, so it is. Yeah, Ryan's speed control is a little off the set. I'm just watching. You know, speed control is a big thing, you know, especially with these two guys, you know.
Yeah, and I was watching his last set against, I believe he played Rob Cole.
Yeah, Rob, yeah.
And he was making good saves, but Rob was kicking out of everything.
Yeah, Rob's really good at kicking. Really good.
So yeah, Tommy's behind the seven here, looking to go
two rails probably. Just maybe. This is a tricky shot right now. He's got him hooked here pretty good.
Yeah, and it looks like if he doesn't make the hit, there's really nothing
tied up. Brian should get out.
Yeah, it could be a deciding shot this game here. So Tommy's really got to take his time. He's looking at all the different angles there.
Yep.
They got the open event going on in the other room.
Yep. Who's on the hot seat for that?
Well, it looks like Tommy DeLfonso and Ray Mack are playing right now. I believe they're both on the undefeated side.
Nice.
You got BTK, Billy the Kid. He's he's squaring off against Georgie Rodriguez out of Brooklyn.
Oh, no, that's a good match.
And I think we got Sam Barrett playing. I'm not sure who she's facing, but I think she beat Billy to put Billy in the loser's side. So she might still be on the winner's side. So I don't know. I'm not 100% sure.
And I think it's a race to four, right? It's a race to four?
Yes, and Mike extended it to a double elimination tournament.
Oh, that's good.
And Tommy's taking a long look at this here. It looks like he's ready. He's made his call here.
Yeah, he's got to be careful because if you hit this too thin, you can scratch the side. He's trying to just like. Nice hit.
Very good. It's a good hit, but five ball still exposed, and Rice should have a good look here.
Yep.
Ten lines up pretty good here. I think he's going to take a swing at it. What do you think, Mark?
Yeah, probably. And that's all you really have. You don't really have anything else. So.
Yeah, he's calling 10.
I think from the start, I figured Ryan would be one of the favorites to do well in this tournament.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. He's been playing real strong. He had a good showing last weekend or two weekends ago in the Joss event.
Yeah. And then, I mean, you got Rich Minicello, you got Rob Pierce, I mean, you got Rob Poley, I mean, you got a lot of good players. I mean, there's, out of these 16 guys, you know. So now, okay, he missed that, so now he left Tom kind of an open out.
Yeah, That's a good shot from Tuckery right there. Yeah. Bumstead got a pretty bad roll, but if it lines up the combo, he's still be able to manage it.
Yeah.
I don't think he wanted to take that combination.
No, no, no. He wanted to be on the other side of it.
Right. So I see Mike got Molinari to sponsor this event.
That's awesome. I mean, I think it's good. I mean, they sponsor my tour as well. I mean, I think it's good for everybody, you know. They got a good product. They have a very, very good product.
And as always, Steve and Regina hosting us here at Snookers for the No Excuses 10-Ball Invitational.
Yep.
Tommy not too happy walking away from the table after that shot.
Yeah. I mean, that still means, I look at it as if you leave the guy long, it's still good, you know. You might not get the safety, but if you leave long, it's good, you know.
Right, looking to duck him behind the eight ball.
That's a great shot. Yeah, oh, yeah, he gets a good shot. It's a very good shot. Yeah, he's as they call it, behind the eight right now. I mean, he's pretty smart, though. Tommy figures out things, though.
I've played with these two for probably about 20 years now.
Oh, wow.
Their game's kind of very similar. There's a lot of Tommy's game in the way Ryan thinks shots and makes shots and vice versa.
Yeah, and
they practice a lot. They play against each other all the time.
That's why I said
there's no mysteries right here. What's going on?
No. They come to tournaments all together a lot. And I even said that to the folks. I'm like, these guys play a lot. These guys know each other, so it's a lot of them.
Yeah, I think Ryan brings out a little gear in Tommy.
Yeah, I think so.
You know, kind of teacher versus student kind of thing. I think he definitely doesn't want to lose this set. So, so they're both bearing down. Yeah, not that they wouldn't normally.
No, but this is a little bit more, this is more important for Ryan because he just, wow, he's
got to hit Tom.
Yeah.
Left him even on the 50-yard line, too.
Yeah. No, because Ryan just lost an match, so now he has to win a snatch. Like
he doesn't want to.
He doesn't
want
to be on the last bubble.
In a row. Yeah, exactly.
He doesn't want to be on the last bubble. So.
He's going to love that eight ball again.
Yeah. Ryan's playing good. He plays smart.
Bottom rail, too. Good shot from Ryan. Yeah. Little safety battle here.
Yeah, that's a good thing. So, one thing about 10 ball, I look at 10 ball like it's kind of like a little bit of 9 ball and 8 ball together because the strategy of 8 ball. And the shot maker of 9 ball.
Yeah, that one extra ball does add a little element, and the breaks aren't as as wide open as they are in 9 ball. That duck and dive mentality happens a little more.
Oh yeah, 10 ball. It takes a lot longer to play 10 ball. Let's see what he's gonna do here.
Tommy thinned it. I don't think that was what he was trying to do.
Yeah. He's gotta be careful with this corner pocket because that rolls in. So, and I'm firsthand, and I know how that table plays.
I think he left the natural angle.
Yeah. Natural angle to come out. This table is a tough table. Play that right now.
Yeah, it really is. Those pockets are pretty unforgiving, and then the rails are bouncy too.
Yep.
So yeah, you got to be in dead stroke when you want to step in front of the folks here on the rail and on the live stream here on table one. Oh, Ryan here with the 9-10.
Yeah.
Maybe two rails play it in the side. It looks like he's queuing that up.
Yeah. Top hit left hand angle if you have two rails.
Get out of there.
Came a little short.
Yeah, he kind of left himself with one of those in between. What do you do?
50-yard line.
Yeah, I think he should be able to cut it right in. That's what he's looking at.
Yeah.
Up to about 3-2. Yep. Handled that real, made it look real easy there.
Yep.
Nice shot from Ryan Guy. Takes a 3-2 lead.
Oops, sorry. Oh, shoot. 3-2.
Mark, was that a three point game?
Yeah, there we go. It has plus, it doesn't have takeaway, so.
No, we're good. That's the score there, 3-2.
Yep.
Rise on the break.
Yeah. Ryan breaks very well. He's known for his break.
And I like how Mike implemented the alternate break here with the 10 ball game. Everybody gets a shot at the table. You know, it's tough for one guy to get you know, a strangle hold on the set.
Actually, I think it's winter break. Winter breaks.
It is winter break. Yeah, it's alternating break on the open event.
Oh, is it? Okay, yeah, they did that for the lesser players, you know, because you know you want to play George Rodriguez and play race the 4-10 ball, and he breaks around the set throwing, you know.
Well, actually, that's who I drew first round, the Joss event.
Yeah, I was watching. I was right there. I was watching. Brian just made two balls on a break. And let's see, he's got a shot in the one.
Looks like he does.
Yeah. So he could get out here, you know.
Yeah, the patterns, I'll be able to see that pattern. The 6-9 looks a little weird.
Yeah, that's about it. And if you could just, you know, like I said, play the one roll.
Yeah, he'll settle the one there for the two. Maybe draw back a little bit, keep that angle.
Yep.
Nope.
Kyle's giving Rob Pierce a good run for his money over there. I think Kyle's on the hill, I think.
Yeah, I seen him make a short rack about a rack and a half, maybe two racks ago, and that gave him a two-game advantage.
Yeah, and then we got Richie's. Richie's up 5-2 over Lucas. I don't know who's winning on Kerry's match. And then we have Jared and Tim Perry over there.
Yeah, I think Jared just tied it up with Buzzsaw over on 7.
Yep, so.
Oh, I missed that? Oh, wow.
No, he made it. Got him.
That looked a little scary.
Yeah, that trickled him.
Yeah, he's in good shape here. Slide over, play the 6 up, or even play it in the opposite corner.
Yep. Okay. He likes to use a lot of draw. I noticed that he doesn't follow the ball, roll the ball. He just likes to fire it in.
Yeah, and he cues everything up at the bottom.
Yeah. I mean, some players do, you know. Everybody has their own way of the style of playing.
Yeah, very good shot there.
Yep. He gets into a rhythm. It's tough to beat. You know, with his break, and you know, he makes ball and pockets ball very well. So, and he plays a very good 8-ball too. So.
Yeah, that's where I first met him playing 8-ball.
On the bar table, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Just like that, 4-2, right?
Yep, 4-2.
All races to 7.
Yep. You know,
triple elimination.
Yeah, very interesting. I
like the random draw.
Yep. Nope, that's good. Because like I said, anybody can play anybody.
And it looks like Monsieur Dennis Levesque moved on from this now with a bye.
Yeah.
Being the 11th guy,
odd
man out on the random draw.
Yes, he got the bye,
And I heard he's been playing real well.
Yeah, he has.
Two wins, and I believe he lost his first match to Tommy. But gathered together and been stroking it good the last two sets.
Yeah, no, Dennis plays well. He does. Just depends on how much Bud Light he has.
Yeah, that does affect everybody's game. In either a good or bad way.
Yeah. I'm the same person. I've been playing pool for a long time. I don't drink. It's my whole thing. Some people it relaxes them. Some people, it, you know.
Well, 4-2 here. I staying on the rack. So yeah, we found out quick. It's winning break.
Yeah. Yeah. It looks like Kyle's gonna. Take a win out from Rocky.
Yeah, that's on 8.
Yep.
Yeah,
I think, okay, so it's 6-4 over there.
6-3.
6-3. So. But Rob's got a lot of work to do. He made a ball.
An excellent break.
Yeah, see the one. You can't see the one.
Yeah, that 3-ball still got in the way, but I hit him good there. Might look to push out here.
Yep.
Oh, he's going airborne.
Oh boy, there we go. He makes it like that.
Yeah, pocketed it. Rye's very good with that jump cue.
Yeah. Like I said, some tournaments allow it and some don't, you know, so, I mean, it's a good one to have, you know, if you're good with it.
Yeah, and he plays a lot of bar box pools, so,
yeah.
And with the Super Billions Expo coming up, they allow that as well, so on those small tables, it's easy to get jammed up.
Oh, yeah.
Being able to jump over balls and pocket balls with it, it's a big advantage to
I don't know if that 10 ball is frozen the rail or...
I think he might be a little bit off.
Okay, so I don't think he can play that fast. I mean, he may be able to light him. He's probably just going to play the shot. I don't know. He's looking at it.
Yeah, he's definitely looking to draw into it. He made one.
Yeah, I saw that earlier. Right.
Number two?
Yeah, right straight into it. I mean, that's a big part of the game, too, you know, the 10 ball, you know. Combos come up a lot.
Yeah, he's looking at it.
It's a very tough shot, though. Yeah, because the five ball's tricky to get to, even if you put inside and come across.
I think he called it, so he's swinging at it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, nice try.
Hit a two-way.
Yeah, I think he did that. Yeah, so he played a two-way.
Well, now she's hanging.
Yeah. But Tom doesn't really have much. So. I mean, he could probably spin around the 10 maybe and try to hit the 3. Or he could probably come, you know, do a one rail spin shot that way. Let's see what he does. Oh, he's even feeling the whole ball. Oh.
Yeah,
okay.
He clipped the 5 on the way by.
Yeah, I thought he had it. Looked like he.
Yeah, that's uncharacteristic of Tommy. Usually when he's queuing the shot up, he's 100% on what's going to happen with that cue ball.
Yeah, seemed a little kind of shaky this set at the beginning. Just, you know, I mean, it's important. And don't forget this one's it's an expensive tournament. You know, it's
true.
$275, so it's, you know, it's a lot of money. Not like playing a $50 tournament or a $60 tournament or $100, you know.
Yeah, it adds a little element to it. These guys, though, are not unaccustomed to playing for little bit of cash.
No, these guys play for cash all the time. So
I think maybe closer to the end that'll get to them.
Yeah, because it's 25. Yeah, because the big end. Yeah.
And then they'll start thinking more about it.
Like,
right now, with 11 players left, though.
Yeah.
If that's bothering them this early, they're going to have a long way. They're going to have a long day.
Oh, yeah.
So probably gets a pretty good angle there to roll up.
That's natural. That's natural.
I was thinking he's taking a little swing at this there, though. He might go to the top rail.
And come back. Yeah. See, this is the problem. See, that's the problem. He got up. He jumped up on that ball.
He did jump.
Yep. And I was telling the folks that, you know, you got to stay with your shot. And very, very important to stay down on that shot until it's done. Because if you watch the professional players play, they're locked in.
Yeah, their mechanics are phenomenal in that basic staying down.
Yeah, and that's what makes you play better. If you, stay down and don't jump up, you get a better chance of making the ball. Yep, Kyle just defeated Rob Pearson.
Yeah, there's the handshake right there, huh?
Yep.
I don't know how many losses Rob has.
That's his first one. That's his first loss.
First?
Yep. I mean, people get hot. Yeah. I mean, it's a race of 7, so, I mean, people can get hot. Because now if you're playing from this table to that table, it's like free throws in a bucket.
Yeah, it's definitely buckets compared to one. Tommy locked him up on the 8, swung at the 10 ball.
Yeah, took a shot at the 10.
He's got a little venom in his face right there. Oh, yeah. He wanted that one.
Because he's down 4-2, so it's like he needs this game. Yeah, he needs this game to have a chance to win.
Definitely a little salty on not making that one. Still got Ryan pretty sticky spot.
Oh, no, here. Ryan's going to get a jump you out, probably. Yeah, let's see.
Well, he's jump cue in his hand.
Yeah, he's got a little jump.
He got a quarter of a ball there.
Yeah, he's going to try to spin it and cut that in the corner like that. All right, that's tough. If you take all the jump cues, all the jump shots you could do, You're looking at probably about 80% of them if they don't make it. You're about 80.
Oh, he'll make the hit, yeah.
Oh, yeah, but I'm just saying. Yeah. Yeah, his percentages are pretty good.
Yeah, with a... When that 7-ball lied, it's... The 9-ball's in the way. This isn't easy to get to the 8.
Yeah, you gotta come three rails.
Three rails into the angle.
Yeah.
That's
the only way you can do it, right?
We'll see. Tommy really hasn't been up at the table to stroke much in the last couple games. So stroke test, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Like I said, you know, these pockets, you've got to hit them. You can't hit anything hard with. You have to hit it like a soft speed. And the problem is, when you have to hit it hard, you have to hit the ball right in the hole.
Yeah, it's got to be dead center on one, or else it will, if it hits the side rail, it will rattle out. Oh, yeah. It just doesn't fall. Yeah.
It's like me, I had a couple five balls when I played Dennis, and I hit them pretty good, and they still didn't go. You know, so I mean, you have to hit them very, very well.
Yeah, you got to really be true on this table for sure.
Yeah.
Oh, Ryan, you got a little angle here.
Yeah, the only thing about bumping balls, too, I tell the audience that, you know, you don't want to bump a ball if you don't have to. You know, just try to stay away from the traffic.
Oh, and he missed it.
Yeah, he jumped up.
Oh, and he got lucky.
Yeah, he got up on that shot. They all miss.
Right. Rice talking to the rail, probably asking him if the pocket moved.
Mm. I think he moved.
I think you're right, Mark. He definitely did jump up.
Oh, my God.
Well, after the miss, Tommy's stepping up here with a pretty tough look at that 8-ball. I believe he could hit it directly, but... Yeah, he's queuing it up, but it goes right past the 9-ball, so.
Yep.
Probably thin it and get back to where the cue's at. We hit it hard to try to make it. That's Ryan, pretty good look.
Yep.
Playing in the side, the two rails. Thinking about it.
Yeah, this is natural.
Yeah, I think that's what he's going to do.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. The only thing is, if you hit it with any kind of speed, I mean, it does go, but these side pockets, I noticed, they're very tough. Jared DiMaggio played a set against Kyle the first set, and the side pockets are brutal. You got to hit them perfect.
Yeah, they're tight.
Yeah, so you're going to hit everything perfect. How much you hit him with that?
Yeah, he hit that one real good. Use that side rail to kill the ball.
Yeah, so he should. Just
really get a commanding lead in this set. Yeah.
Yeah, it's gonna make it. If he makes this, it's gonna make it 5-2.
Looks like Rye's gonna have Tommy clean the cue. Okay.
Yep.
Ryan Lineham 5-2.
Yep,
5-2. Race to 7.
Yeah, this is going to be a tough one for Tom to come back, but he is able to. You know, anybody can come back. But.
Yeah, it's discouraging, too, when Ryan misses a couple shots there in that last game and he comes to the table and he's still tucked behind balls.
Yeah, that's the ball with the roll.
Yes. I mean, Tommy does have the mental toughness to get over that and still play well, but...
Yeah. Just got to do your best, you know? That's all you can do. So we got a good little match over there with TP, with Bussar and Jared, so...
Yeah, what's that, 4-3 now?
Yeah, I don't know. So, yeah, Jared just won that game, I think, so... It'll be 4-4. See what we got for Richie's match. Okay, Richie's, it's a 5-3 race with him and... And it's 4-4, I'm sorry, no, 3-3, with Kerry and Rob Paul. Looks like Kerry's putting Rob Paul to sleep.
Yeah, he has a tendency to do that. He does play slow.
Oh, yeah.
Very methodical.
Yeah,
very strong player.
Yeah, no, he plays good.
10 ball drops on him, right?
That gets spotted, right? Yeah, that gets spotted and they continue to shoot, right?
Yes.
That doesn't happen very often. Do they know the time they are? I don't think they know the 10 ball drop.
Somebody tell him the 10 ball drop. 10 ball drop. Yeah, right, I have no idea.
That's what he said. That would be kind of funny if they went through the whole rack and then the...
Oh, it was close. He was moving.
Yeah, yeah. I wonder what happened there, though.
I don't know.
No, I'm just saying, you know, if you're shooting, can you shoot them, you don't see the 10, then, you know?
That's Mike. He would know.
Yeah.
We'll have to ask him when he comes over.
Yeah.
Now, what are we doing?
That's an interesting rule. That'd be something different, you know?
Yeah, that's the first that it didn't. Unfortunately, it didn't happen, and we caught him. But,
yeah, yeah. But I'm just saying.
Yeah, know? No, I agree. We gotta ask him. Tommy tries to lock him up, and it peaks.
Oh, yeah.
He is unhappy with that.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's what happens. When the rolls don't go your way, they don't go your way.
Yeah, wide open table now for Rye. He's been hitting him pretty good the last couple games.
Yeah. You know, he should get out here. This should be, you know.
Well, yeah, I mean, the way they lay right now, it looks like.
The only problem is maybe unless he gets tied up with the 8 and the 9. That's the only thing, if he doesn't draw enough. But he's okay, so. I'm going to play that probably the 3. Yep. Okay, three,
yeah, he comes between the 6 and the 7 here.
Yep. Oh, yeah. Just roll this up.
Yep. Roll it up. Play short side.
Yep.
He's in good shape here. Yeah.
He can roll over the balls when he wants to. I mean, I think he just likes to like freewheel and like. I think that's his whole thing. He likes just boom, 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 that's it.
Yeah, okay. Like you said earlier, he likes cueing everything up with the bottom.
Yeah.
And stroking through the ball.
Sometimes that gets you in trouble, though. The more, like, Darren Appleton said, the American players move the cue ball too much. If you look at the European players, they're very simple. Very center ball, a lot of center ball, a lot of high ball. Not as much movement on the cue ball. No, he might be in a little. I think he's straight on his ball.
Yeah, right? He's a little straighter than he wanted him to be, but.
Yeah. I mean, he could
again,
do something with it a little
again,
bit.
Keeling up bottom. Looks like he's going to draw the side rail.
Oh, yeah.
Right behind the 8. Well, he's going to have to bump it now. Like you said earlier.
Yeah,
really
you don't know.
No. He's going to draw right behind it, never mind.
Yeah, but I mean, playing the same. Yeah, there you go.
He's
good.
Shot.
Yeah, he does very well.
It's a 6-3, a 6-2.
Yeah, it's a nice shot. Nice shot.
Yeah, yeah. Tommy's still upset about that safety kick there on that one ball.
Yeah.
He's not happy.
That I'll tell you that that's a place with your mind. You gotta just like let things go on.
So as we look around the room. You got Dennis Levesque back up on table 5 practicing hitting balls.
Yep.
Looks like Kerry and Rob still at 3. No, it looks like Kerry took a 4-3 lead and they're going to take a timeout.
Yeah. Yeah, I think Kerry does very well, like you said, because he's very slow and methodical. And he takes a lot of players, not saying out of the rhythm, but like if he played somebody like Ryan, a very fast player, pace player, it may drive them nuts. Literally, may, you know. Me, I play a little slower, so, and that doesn't really bother me. I do pretty well against Kerry and certain players. Like, you know, everybody has their own people
right.
That they can't beat or they can beat, or, you know, so.
Yeah, I can see how Kerry's speed can be kryptonite to some players,
yes,
for sure.
Yes, yes.
A dry break there from Rye guy.
Yeah, I'm surprised. Yep. Tom's gonna do something here. He's gonna wake up.
Yeah, this is opportunity here. At least to try and control the table if he can't get out.
Yeah, the three ball's a little tricky. That's the one that's really kind of tied up there.
Tommy. Tommy, who won the match between him and Ray Mack.
Chelsea there, because she was running the tournament, I think.
Right back up to the table.
That just seems like what happens is you start falling behind and you start making mental mistakes, and that's what happens. I mean, you don't play the way you're supposed to play normally.
Yeah, they seem to compound themselves.
Yep. So like actually watching your match with George. You know, you made a few mistakes, and you know,
right.
he got a little bit of an edge, and then boom, 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 boom. And that's what happens, you know.
And you can look up and you're down.
8-1.
Yeah, 8-1.
And not taking anything away from you or anything, or even it could happen to Timmy, it could happen to anybody. Because, you know, it's the momentum.
A little safe there from the drive, but Tommy gets up quick, looks like he's got a hit on it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. He actually might be able to make this. But yeah, he made that.
Sure, he had no love.
Oh, fuck, sorry. Ooh, sorry.
That's how they're rolling with Tommy today. At least he missed that.
But like I said, the rolls dictate everything.
Yeah, he hasn't gotten many favorable ones in this set.
Oh, no,
sure.
I'm not going to be love.
Yeah, Tommy did beat Mackie in the open event over there at the robot table.
Oh, who did? Who won?
Shorty did.
Oh, nice.
Back good hit there. He locked Ryo up behind the nine there.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, then Ryo got his little jumpy cue. I'll try to do something with it.
Yeah, I don't know if it's in play here. I think he's going to have to kick it.
Yeah, he's going to have to. Oh, I don't know if he's trying to jump with his regular folks here. You can not stay around this.
Well, he's going airborne, you're right.
Yeah.
He feels real comfortable with that thing.
Yeah, I mean, that's what it is. I mean, if you take that, that's the whole thing. It's like when he gambles, he needs that cue. If he doesn't have that cue, that's like a stipulation. Yeah, so that's tough. I would try to kick it one right, you know, that way. Now Tommy has to get out here. If he doesn't get out, then...
Yeah, I think he's... It's one of them must...
Yes.
Must win games, obviously, because Ryan's on the hill. But Sutton, he's not going to be eliminated from the tournament.
No.
So going forward, can't climb the ladder.
Yeah, but I mean, it's like, because he's undefeated, so it's like kind of like, you know, you want to...
Okay, he's taking a peek at the 4-10.
Oh, well, I mean, he's kind of desperate, so what do you got to do?
I think that got by there with the angle we got.
Yeah.
I already missed it.
Like I said, you're... kind of desperate, so you have nothing.
Yeah, he just said it as he's walking back to the chair. He's like, I gotta do something.
Yeah. That's not a great angle.
He looks like he might have to play this all the way up to draw in between the 6 and 9 mark.
Yeah.
Although it's pretty straight.
That's what I said. No, that's what I said. He's on the wrong. No, he's on the wrong side of the ball.
Yeah, you're right.
The only thing he can do is just roll up and try to play the 6-9 combo. That's the only really thing you can really do.
Yeah.
Or I mean, or you can draw it and play a bank shot. That's the only other thing. Only other option you have.
Yeah, I pretty much can tell you he's not going to try for the bank shot.
No.
Sure,
he tried to do too much with the cue. He's got in his cue. Alright, so that gives Laz what they call life after death. For Mr. Bertrand. So.
Yeah, a new look on life here right now.
Yeah.
For sure. Now a ball in hand. He's queuing up that shot to go behind the 6 there in between.
Yeah, you have to. You have a choice. You know, you got to do it.
Mm-hmm. Mark Saw Perry looking for some baby powder.
Yeah,
boots.
That must be. I just used a glove. I mean, I thought he had gloves. You know, okay, so here's a little tricky little angle here. But if you can just soft roll this ball. I mean, his angle's a little tricky, so he might have to go up and down.
Yeah, I think he plays this to the top rail and it comes back behind the eight.
Yeah. The only problem is, like I said, these tight pockets, so they're just hitting them with any kind of speed.
Yeah, he hit that pretty strong.
Yeah, but let's see. Okay, not bad.
Yeah, he's in really good shape right there. That's a good shot.
He's come across.
Well, he sees the pattern, that's for sure, right now.
Oh, yeah.
Can you bear down?
Yeah. I mean, Ryan's up 6-2, so I mean, it's still anybody's ball game, but like I said, Ryan's playing very well, so. Yeah, it looks like Rich Manichello's on the hill. Rich just missed a 6-ball.
I am, thank you.
Okay, so narrows the gap. 6-3 now.
Yeah, it's a much needed game there for Tommy.
Yep. A lot of good players here, I'd say. You know, a lot of talented players.
Yeah, and Tommy has the speed to.
Oh, he can win four games.
Sure.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you know, he's capable. I was playing in the Josh tournament, and I was down 4, or it was a race to 9. I was down 6-0. Oh no, it was a race of 7, I'm sorry, I was down 6-0 and I came back and won 7-6.
Wow.
So, on the loose side. So, that's one thing is you never, ever, ever give up in life.
That is true.
You know.
And Tommy doesn't have that bone in his body, he doesn't have to give up bones. So this should be a fight still.
Oh yeah. A lot of players don't do that though, they kind of give up, you know, like when you're gambling or action, you're down like, you know, in a race of 7, you're down 5 games, whatever. The guy just wants to flip the coin. Me, I want to crawl back and try to just, like Nelson does. Nelson just claws.
You're talking about Nelson Oliveira.
Yeah, Nelson just, yep, he just does not quit, ever. You know, he's that's why they call him the Bulldog.
Yeah, I kind of nicknamed him the Portuguese Pitbull.
Yeah, I mean Pitbull, yeah.
From my friend Adam Blair.
Yep.
But yeah, now Tommy's on a rack here. Where's he been breaking from? I didn't catch the games he did break. He's right there, right in the middle. All right. Made the ball on the side. It looked like a 5-ball, but then gets snookered behind the 10. So it looks like a push out here.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's looking to see where the safe spot to push is. So he's going to come here to this side now.
Yep. And anytime you play safe, you want to leave distance. If you can't like lock them up, you want to leave distance. So what could he do here?
Yeah, he's going to be careful, though. He pushes to a spot where it's too good. Rye's going to say, go ahead.
Yep.
The second there, I was thinking that he was taking a look to actually swing at the kick.
Yeah.
Well, okay. He ties up the 2 there, pushes to an open spot. Rye's got a good look at this one.
You can probably thin on the left side of the 1 and bring the 1 over there and then bring the cue ball this way.
The 1 towards the 9,
yeah,
you're saying?
Yeah, you could do that. I mean, there's a couple options. You could do that. You could put the 1 on the short rail here. I mean, long rail, I'm sorry. I mean, there's a lot of options here.
I think that's what he's going to do. Keep the 1 on the long rail. Well, yeah.
Yeah, like I said, you know.
Right, he's been there.
Yeah, like I said, just like, you know. He wanted to kind of leave it. Like.
Yeah, he didn't want to push the one that far for sure.
No.
Well, no, Tommy steps up. Pretty decent look to control this table.
Yeah, it's all about controlling the table.
Looks like Buzzsaw is breaking.
Yeah, I think he's up. Yeah, he's up 5-4.
He just moved the bead 5-4.
Yeah, he's gonna be a tough one to beat. Well, thing with Timmy is, thank you. Thing with Timmy is he's very good when he's ahead, and when Timmy is like a very close match, then it's tough. You know, he makes a few mistakes here and there like that, but he feels comfortable. It's like anything else. I think it same thing with all the players. You know, if they're ahead, they're gonna feel comfortable.
Oh, yeah, I love it when I'm ahead. That's a good feeling.
Yep. Well, sometimes you feel overconfident, though.
Tommy queuing this up the bottom right.
Yeah, so it's two rails, I think. Yep, it's like two rails.
He's getting pretty good, but that 10 ball is real big right now.
Yep. Now he's going to have to kick.
Yeah, he's definitely going to have to kick out it because that 10 ball is looming large right there. He can't spin that. And at the angle he's at, it's a real weird kick. He's definitely not happy with the way the cue ball laid out right here. The right guy on the hill, this shot.
Oh, yeah.
The magnitude is pretty severe, yeah. That's a good hit from Tommy.
Oh yeah.
But
it's kind of like
some ball peaks and he throws his hands up.
Yep. Yeah, we know it. That's
that
all.
Could be. That could be.
That could be all she wrote.
The beginning of the end here.
As Frank Sinatra says, "This is the end."
Rye overrolled that maybe a little bit.
I told you this whole set I've been watching has been overrunning a little bit.
Yeah, he overrolled that one. He overran one against Rob Old too that cost him. He scratched when he was on the hill.
Richie Manichello just beat Lucas 7-5. Lucas has now two losses.
That's a young kid right there.
Oh yeah, for 15 years old.
15. I asked Mikey, did they card before these guys got in? He shoots really strong for a young player like that.
He plays what they call, he free strokes everything.
Oh yeah, reminds me of the kid back in the day.
Yeah, the other kid, yep. Like basically an autopilot. They're playing on autopilot. Yeah, Ryan's gonna follow. Yeah, he'll follow this from under it underneath the 10. Yeah, there we go. That should be LC loaded.
Yeah, he's in closing time mode right now.
Oh, yeah. If hit that top rail, I'm gonna get the 10. Be good. But Lucas is only gonna get better, you know.
Yep, Rice settles behind this one. Play right in the side.
That's it. Nice shot.
It's a little past Tommy there.
Yeah. That's it. 7-3.
Well, the two Rhode Island guys had to play each other.
Nothing they
can do. Rice comes out on top this time. But Tommy's not out.
No. He's got one loss, though. They both have one loss now. So. Now, TP has zero losses, Richie Minicello has zero losses, Kerry has zero losses, Rob Hole has zero losses. I think that's it. I think Dennis, I don't know how many losses Dennis has, I think one or two.
So we're going to have to talk to Mike to find out what match is going to be on
yes.
the stream.
Well, I know that the winner stays on, so Ryan's going to stay on top. So he's gonna be here. So he's just waiting for an opponent.
Okay. Now is Mikey waiting for the other two matches here?
See, I don't know.
We got Buzzsaw and
yeah.
Okay.